A major shortcoming of using pairwise key exchange based on a shared secret is that it cannot scale. That is, suppose we use the shared master keys as a way to establish and exchange the new session key. This scheme does not scale easily. That is, Alice needs to share a master key with Bob, and then another master key with Carol, and so on and so forth. Using a key distribution center, or KDC, can solve this scalability problem. Each party has his or her own master key shared with the KDC. That is, the KDC has many master keys, one for each party. But each party only keeps one master key that is shared with the KDC. So for example, Alice has KA that is shared with KDC, and Bob has KB that is shared with KDC. Now suppose Alice and Bob wants to have a secure session. Therefore, they need a session key KS. First, Alice sends a request to KDC, saying that I need a key to talk to Bob, along with a nonce and one. A nonce is a random value. Then the KDC sends a message back to Alice that is encrypted using the master key KA that is shared between Alice and KDC. This message contains the session key KS that the KDC just created for Alice and Bob to share. The message also contains the same request that Alice sent to KDC, along with the same nonce value N1, and a message we call ticket. The ticket is encrypted using the master key KB that is shared between Bob and KDC, and it contains the session key KS and the ID of Alice. When Alice gets back the message from the KDC, she can decrypt it because she has the master key KA, and so she can extract the session key KS. And she knows that the message is from the KDC and is fresh. That is, it is not a replay, because only the KDC can use KA to encrypt properly a message that contains the original request and the nonce that she just sent. Alice then sends the ticket to Bob. Know that only Bob can decrypt the ticket because it is encrypted using KB, the master key shared between Bob and the KDC. In fact, when Bob decrypts the ticket, he knows that the ticket is created by the KDC because only the KDC can encrypt the ID of Alice properly. And he knows that the session key KS was created by KDC and is for communication with Alice. Then Bob sends a message that contains a nonce N2, which is a random value, and his ID, encrypted using the session key KS, to Alice. When Alice receives this message, she knows that she is communicating with Bob because only he can decrypt the ticket and get a session key KS and encrypt the ID properly. Alice then performs an agreed-upon transformation on N2, say, add 100 to N2, and encrypt the result using KS and sends it back to Bob. This proves to Bob that he is communicating with Alice because only she has a session key KS.